Here you go. I must have searched every shelf in the library.
Hey, if I could make a book appear by magic, I would.
Yeah, and maybe you can make them weigh less.
And a way to get the latest scientific data as soon as it's published?
And a way to talk with someone who's actually in one of these countries that we're writing about?
Shh! There's another way.
Let me show you.
Water is central to the existence of life on Earth as we know it.
Water is the only substance found on Earth as liquid.
Water's my will and my way.
Nearly a billion people lack access to a safe supply of water.
Out of the small waves,
every dollar invested in water and sanitation provides an economic return
not a drop of our danger.
Ah, finally, I see. Thank you.
From the sea to the tree,
turning pages like leaves,
building bridges when we breathe,
stories never out of reach.
From the seed to the tree,
turning pages like leaves,
building bridges when we breathe,
stories never out of reach.
Welcome to the new library, everybody!
Russell's messages.
Broken serving sentences.
We be between the lines.
Better sight us if you're so inclined.
Renovate a mind state.
Maybe ladies, but still penetrate.
Our power's on a conscious tip.
Coming with the knowledge we inherited.
Broken services.
Yep, versus surfaces. We be between the lines. Better sight us if you so inclined. Renovate a mind state.
Yo, we take it backwards, half heard, half spoken. While you're horoscoping for good fortune, we stay floating thin lines. It's the signs of the times. Hell is dimes plus two. Pack a double dimes to you. So sick with it when we rush through. Turning tables to untangle truth from lie. Devil's pie, got them hyped. Think they lost and you ride. We take flight on the left wing.
Make your soul sing.
Holy, holy, you can't hold us in a box. When the beat drops, we rock. We just keep flowing, keep moving it. Hollis, where you at? I know you be doing it.
I would be doing it. You know that we pursuing it. Yup, they say literature is close to extinction, but we coming from the margins and transform the diction and the friction sparks a fire up under your seat. We building on the baseline, flowing underneath. Read up to get down. Definition through sound. Architectural integrity is playfully profound. Hold yourself by your spine, cause our bodies are books carefully bound. We sing a nice hook, got the ground shook. Got information flowing instantaneously through our arteries. Authoring philosophy classically, we do it like our language is Latin, because you know you got a Rosetta Stone, the canon, to understand it. Rosetta Stone, the canon, just to understand it.
Yo, yeah, yo. Restless messages,
breaking surface sentences.
We be between the lines.
Better sight us if you're so inclined.
Renovate a mind state,
maybe ladies, but still penetrate.
Our power's on a conscious tip.
Come in with the knowledge we inherited.
Restless messages,
breaking surface sentences.
We be between the lines. Better sight us if you're so inclined. Renovate a mind state,
renovate a mind state, breaking surface sentences.
We be between the lines.
Better sight us if you're so inclined.
Renovate a mind state.
Renovate your mind state. Yay!
Give it up for the library. Woo!
Thank you.
In a moment, we're going to get our shovels out and we're going to dig some dirt and we're going to get it started. And 15 months later, we're going to be moving in to this wonderful new facility at the university. This is an historic landmark in the university's history. It's part of a campaign that we're just wrapping up, a campaign that rocketed through the goal of $160 million and is now $165 million. And I want to recognize one of the co-chairs of the campaign that's also with us, John Meisenbaugh. John, would you raise your hand? Here's John Meisenbaugh. John, together with Ann and Jim Sinegal, the three co-chairs of our wonderful campaign for the difference we make, and I want to thank them for their leadership, their time, and their generosity to this campaign. This is going to transform Seattle University. There's never been a building at Seattle University that's ever made such a difference as this building will make. It's at the very heart of our university. It's the academic core around which all of our 8 colleges and schools are surrounded. Just like the Chapel of St. Ignatius gave us a spiritual core for our university, and the Student Center gave us a social core, this is the academic heart of Seattle University for learning, for research, for collaboration of faculty and staff. This is an exciting day for Seattle University, not only in the beginning of a new structure, a new building, but a new era in terms of our academic prowess at the university. And now I'd like to introduce Anne to say a few words. She's been critical to our success. Please greet again Anne Farrell.
Thank you. I am excited today. Particularly, Steve mentioned that we'll be moving into the library in 2010. That is 1 year earlier than had been originally been planned. We are breaking ground 1 year earlier than planned. So this is exciting. We are pleased and truly fortunate. You know, it's a good thing we aren't starting this campaign today. The economy would not be at our backs the way it was a couple of years ago. Not to say that it's been easy, but we're really fortunate that we started as early as we did. We started with a goal of $35.5 million, and today we have raised $37.5 million. And there's still 6 weeks to go in the campaign. It doesn't close until June 30th, so who knows what the final number will be. But it has allowed us to start early, and it's allowed us to do more than we had originally thought we could with this building. So we're really pleased about that. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge the fact that we received a $10 million challenge grant from the Gates Foundation. And David Bly is here somewhere in this audience. David? You know, not only is that the largest gift that's ever been given to Seattle University, but it was a matching gift, and so it was necessary for us to match it, and we did. So that became $20 million. And David, we're so pleased that you're here today, and I want you to go back to the Gates Foundation and tell them all how thrilled we are and how fortunate we feel to have had their support and yours. Thank you. There were many other corporations that stepped up as well, the Boeing Company, the Murdoch Trust, the Paul Allen Foundation, Safeco, Washington Mutual, and a number of others, and then, of course, a number of very important individual donors as well. Steve's going to recognize a couple of those in a minute, but I would like to talk about the fact that we've had a committee that has helped me and Steve in this endeavor. There were 15 library committee members, and every single one of them has made a generous gift, has assisted us with making calls and identifying people that might be interested in the library. And I think that we can all say that those that we found that were willing to support the library are now just as excited about this project as we are. So we've made some new friends. We've brought a lot of Seattle University people together for this important event. There are a number of my committee here today. Not everyone was in town, but I'd like them all now to come up and join me on the stage. I'm tell you how much it means to me to have worked with each of these people. They have been good friends and hard workers and loyal supporters and just an intrepid committee from start to finish. So give them a round of applause. I don't know in quite which order they are behind me, but I want you to know that Bob Blethyn is here. Maybe he'll raise his hand. Father Jerry Cobb, Mary Dunham, Henry James, Maureen Lee, Gordon McHenry, Mary Williams, and Tom Piggott. And I'm particularly glad to have John Meisenbach join us because John and Jim Senegal and I have co-chaired the overall committee, and it's nice to have you here for the library celebration. Thanks, John. Mary Kay McFadden, where are you? You know, most of you know Mary Kay even better than I do, although I know her pretty well, and I just have a great admiration for her and love her as a person. She's our Vice President for University Advancement, and along with Jim Hembry, who is the Senior Development Officer in charge of this library project, and all the other people in the development office, please give them a round of applause. And I told you at the beginning, we're starting this whole project a year earlier, sooner than we planned. And Steve, sooner means we can start now.
Thanks, Ann. It's great to be up here and to be able to look around and just see who's gathered here. People, friends of the university and students and faculty members and people who work at the university. It's just great. Thank you all for being here for this groundbreaking. It's been a while since we've done a groundbreaking like this at the university, and I'd like to thank particularly two people who have helped make this possible. And one is a very close friend of mine, Rita Dobbinsbeck. Her husband, Harold Dobbinsbeck, was here at Seattle University, at Seattle College in 1932, 1936. So he came here just when Father McGoldrick came, and he was very, very devoted to Father McGoldrick, and they made decision to make a significant gift to the library at Seattle University in order to be able to name the McGoldrick Learning Commons. So let's thank Rita Dobbinsbeck right here. Just last week or so, we celebrated the first anniversary of Harold's death, and it was a dear, dear friend of ours. He had more stories about the old days at Seattle University than you could believe, and he would be amazed at the gathering here and what this new library and learning commons is going to be, and especially that it'll be named in favor of his mentor and friend, Father McGoldrick. And the other person is right over here, and this is Ann Wyckoff. And Ann Wyckoff, yes, there she is. Anne is a trustee emerita of Seattle University and has been a generous friend and donor of everything that Seattle University has done for many, many years, and she made a very significant gift also for this library and learning. Because thank you again, Anne Wyckoff. Now let me give you a little bit of instructions about what we're going to do, because we're going to go out of this cool interior space into the hot 88-degree weather. We called the Franciscans and asked them to pray for good weather, and we got it here for this groundbreaking. My old line is, if you want money, pray, ask the Jesuits to pray. If you want good weather, ask the Franciscans. We're going to go outside, and we're going to have a groundbreaking of the, we're going to shovel some dirt of the groundbreaking for the new Learning Commons, which is immediately behind us. And we'll have the campaign chairs and the committee and the trustees and others do it at the first couple of sets of people. But then we'd invite everyone also to join us, and to everyone here is invited to dig a little dirt for the new library and learning commons. And when we do the first one, I'd ask you to join me in a countdown of 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, so forth, down to, I think you know where it goes. The last time there was a groundbreaking on this site was April the 6th, 1965. And Father Lemieux broke ground for the Lemieux Library in 1965. And remarkably, librarians are people that like to keep things and stow them away. And they stowed away the shovel that was used at that groundbreaking. And it's right here. Could I have this shovel for just a second? And could I have this shovel over there, too? I mean, isn't that amazing? I don't know where they tucked this stuff away. I want to find that vault where all this... And it says, Father Lemieux, Memorial Library, groundbreaking, April the 6th, 1965. So these are the shovels that we're going to use for the groundbreaking in 2009 for our new Lemieux Library and Learning Commons. I don't think they're fragile. Do take care of them. They're 45 years old. And they're going to be carried by two of our students, Ryan Rodriguez and Anna Marie Francis. So Ryan, here you go. And Anna Marie, there they are, our two shovel bearers. Now, I don't know if you all know this story, but the thing that is remembered from the last time that Seattle University moved into a new library was that they transported all of the books from the fourth floor of the liberal arts building over to Lemieux Library, and they did a book brigade all the way across with students and faculty from the liberal arts building to the Lemieux. So that's why you're really here, folks. If you got a couple of hours and you're dressed for it, we'll give you boxes and we'll do a human chain for four blocks over to the temporary library. We'll move everything out of here and we'll be all set for the temporary library, and they can go at this building. Just kidding. So let's move now to the groundbreaking again. Thanks for coming, and let's everybody come on outside and let's join in the groundbreaking for this wonderful new project. Thank you. Here we go, folks, for the largest ever capital project of Seattle University for the new Lemieux Library and Learning Commons, McGoldrick Learning Commons. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you. Here we are, members of the Library Committee from the campaign, together with our Provost, Isaiah Crawford, and our Librarian, John Popko. Okay, on three. Okay. On three. One, two, three. Right. Thank you.